So the key with decision bridge technology is it's about linking from finding information, understanding it, to taking an action. In anything, you need to make good decisions to be successful. To improve, you either need to make a better decision than you would have done before, or you need to make the same decision but quicker. So if you look at where we've been with digital initiatives, a lot of it has been focused on just getting the information in front of people. So dashboards. Can I see it on the web? Can I have access to it? But that doesn't make you more efficient. You still need to do something with it. And the way that's been done for years is by copying and pasting into office documents. People put it in Excel, they make a PowerPoint, they send a report by email. So the actual whole process of getting to the point where you've made the decision isn't getting any quicker. And it's still the case, if you just get a dashboard, you don't speed up the overall decision-making process. You may help people become better informed about what's going on, but you need to look at the whole workflow in order to get more efficient. And that's where decision bridge technology comes in. It's about the in-between things that help you speed up the overall workflow. So, for example, moving from where you can see information to actually doing work on it, then distributing it or recording an action.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, so many times we've seen clients over the years just, having dashboards there, they know what's going on, but then they spend so much time just copying and pasting information. Typically, they use Excel to do some calculations, and they typically from there copy paste into PowerPoint because managers want to see PowerPoint and typically gets emailed. The other problem with that is, where's the record of where the last decision and the document is? It's just in an inbox somewhere. And it's, the key thing about Decision Bridge, as you said, Marie, is completely optimizing the whole process, because engineers managing a field, they have very little time. They don't have time for this copy pasting. It's going to be, it's completely inefficient.
I think that's an important time point, Joel, because that time is hidden. It's a hidden loss, if you like, in the system. Because you can get to the point where, like, oh, I know what the right decision is now. But if you then have to go and open a spreadsheet, type it in, or copy paste it out, you've gone back into slow mode. And 30 minutes of a senior person's time is, if you work 8 hours a day, that's a 16th of their day.